Oh, we can easily travel forward in time, and we've known how to do that since 1905.
Have you ever wondered what it would be like to travel through time? Imagine being able to revisit the past, to relive some of your most treasured memories. Or perhaps you dream of journeying into the future, to glimpse the marvels that await humanity. Just a few months ago, a couple of scientists at Cambridge University discovered a way for humans to travel back in time, and it is set to have unimaginable effects on everything. What is time travel? How did the scientists come up with the process? Can it be trusted? Join us in this video as we show how the first successful time travel experiment has been conducted. Time travel is a captivating concept that has fueled the human imagination for centuries. The mere thought of traveling backward or forward in time to witness historical events, correct past mistakes, or peer into the future has fascinated minds across cultures and eras. This idea appeared in myths, legends, and philosophical discussions long before it became a subject of scientific inquiry. It also has grown to be one of the most compelling themes in literature, movies, and scientific inquiries, unveiling a realm of scientific and philosophical intricacies. The concept of time travel encompasses the hypothetical ability to navigate across different points in time, transcending the linear progression of past, present, and future as perceived in our daily lives. While the idea has predominantly remained within the domain of science fiction, theoretical physicists have explored its feasibility within the bounds of known scientific principles. The notion of time travel has roots in ancient Greek mythology, with stories of figures like Kronos and the Moirai possessing the ability to manipulate time. These mythological accounts can be seen as a reflection of the deep-seated human fascination with time's passage and the possibility of transcending its constraints. In the 18th century, the British philosopher John Locke delved into the philosophical implications of time travel in his work, An Essay Concerning Human Understanding. He considered the concept of personal identity through time and the paradoxes that might arise from altering the past. However, the advent of modern physics in the 20th century brought a new dimension to the exploration of time travel as scientists began to develop theoretical frameworks that could accommodate the possibility of traversing through time. From a scientific standpoint, delving into time travel involves complex notions within the realm of theoretical physics. Theoretical frameworks, such as Einstein's theory of relativity and its implications on space-time, have laid the groundwork for comprehending the possibility of time travel. Wormholes, black holes, and closed time-like curves are among the theoretical constructs scientists have contemplated as potential gateways to traverse temporal dimensions. However, many of these concepts face significant challenges, including paradoxes such as the famous grandfather paradox, highlighting the paradoxical nature of altering the past and the intricacies of causality. In 1915, Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity revolutionized our understanding of gravity and space-time. The theory introduced the concept of closed time-like curves, also known as CTCs, hypothetical paths in space-time that allow a particle to return to its past. While the existence of CTCs remains a matter of debate, they have become a cornerstone of theoretical discussions on time travel. One approach suggests that CTCs could be generated by rotating massive objects near the speed of light, creating a tunnel through space-time. Another theoretical approach involves the concept of wormholes, hypothetical tunnels that connect two distant points in space-time. These tunnels, first proposed by physicist John Wheeler, could allow for travel between different regions of the universe or even between different times. Another layer of complexity and intrigue to the exploration of time travel is the introduction of quantum mechanics into the picture. Quantum entanglement is a strange and weird phenomenon where two or more particles become linked in such a way that they share the same fate regardless of their separation. This new science has opened up new possibilities for manipulating information and potentially influencing events in the past. One theoretical approach involves utilizing entangled particles to send information back in time. Imagine sending an entangled particle into a hypothetical CTC. If the entangled particle inside the CTC could then interact with its counterpart in the present, it could theoretically transmit information backward in time, effectively altering the past. Another approach involves using quantum entanglement to manipulate the state of particles in the past. By exploiting the interconnectedness of entangled particles, it might be possible to retroactively modify the outcomes of past events. Although the concept of time travel is exciting, it is still steeped in intense debate and speculation. The theoretical approaches proposed so far also face significant challenges and limitations. One major challenge lies in the violation of causality, the principle that effects cannot precede their causes. If time travel were possible, it would allow for events to be altered in the past, potentially causing causes to follow their effects. Another challenge lies in the energy requirements for manipulating space-time or creating wormholes. The immense amounts of energy required are far beyond the capabilities of current technology. Additionally, the stability and practicality of wormholes remain uncertain. They could collapse at any moment, trapping travelers inside. But beyond all the scientific conversations, time travel raises important philosophical questions about the nature of reality, free will, and the fabric of the universe. The idea of changing events that have happened in the past or influencing those that will happen in the future raises conversations and concerns along the idea of determinism and free will. If time travel were possible, would the changed past create new timelines, or would changes propagate throughout history, potentially affecting the present and future? These philosophical quandaries spark debates on the nature of causation and the malleability of existence. Time travel also introduces ethical dilemmas. The ability to change events in the past may lead to unintended consequences or disrupt the natural course of history. Questions about the responsibilities and consequences of altering past events emerge, highlighting the ethical considerations associated with manipulating time. Despite the challenges and limitations, the exploration of time travel continues to push the boundaries of our understanding of physics and the universe. Scientists are constantly seeking new theoretical frameworks and technological advancements that could bring the possibility of time travel closer to reality. The study of time travel, whether it remains purely theoretical or becomes a technological reality, holds immense value. It forces us to confront fundamental questions about the nature of time, causality, and the fabric of the universe. It also challenges our conventional understanding of reality and opens up new avenues for exploring the cosmos and our place within it. This constant search by scientists to find a theoretical framework that could make time travel possible has recently yielded positive results. By exploring quantum entanglement, scientists say they have successfully simulated a method of backward time travel that allowed them to change an event after the fact 1 out of 4 times. The Cambridge University team is quick to caution that they have not built a time machine, per se, and also note how their process doesn't violate physics while changing past events after they have happened. According to the lead author, David Arvidsson Shukur from the Cambridge Hitachi Laboratory, imagine that you want to send a gift to someone. You need to send it on day 1 to make sure it arrives on day 3. However, you only receive that person's wish list on day 2. To respect the gift recipient's timeline, you would need to send it on day 1. But, as Arvidsson Shukur notes, you won't know what gift to send until later, meaning your gift will either be late or be wrong. Now imagine you can change what you send on day 1 with the information from the wish list received on day 2, he adds. It is exactly this phenomenon that the researchers say can happen in the right scenario. The researchers claim that their simulation uses quantum entanglement manipulation to show how you could retroactively change your previous actions to ensure the outcome is the one you want. In their simulations, which were published in the journal Physical Review Letters, the Cambridge research team simulated the entanglement of two particles. One of the particles is then sent off to be used in an experiment. After the experiment's completion, they gained new information, which would have caused them to act differently. In this situation, the study's co-author, Nicole Junger Halpern, a researcher at the National Institute of Standards and Technology and the University of Maryland, explained that the experimentalist manipulates the second particle to effectively alter the first particle's past state, changing the outcome of the experiment. This means that by changing the remaining particle, the researchers change the past, at least in their simulations. It's an effect the researchers described as remarkable. However, there is a catch. The experiment only changes the past with the new information about 25% of the time. This means that the simulation has a 3 in 4 chance of failure. According to Arvidsson Shukur, this means 1 out of 4 times, the gift will be the desired one, for example, a pair of trousers. Another time, it will be a pair of trousers but in the wrong size or the wrong color, or it will be a jacket. Fortunately, in their simulations, they at least know when they have failed, which can still allow the researcher to rework the system to effectively achieve backward time travel and get the result that they wanted. To achieve this seemingly impossible goal, they propose using a filter that will allow their theoretical experimenter to send several solutions and then simply filter out the 75% that they didn't want. One of the commentators on the study's results and a co-author of the study, Aidan McConnell, PhD, who carried out this research during his master's degree at the Cavendish Laboratory in Cambridge, wrote, "Let's say sending gifts is inexpensive, and we can send numerous parcels on day one. On day two, we know which gift we should have sent. By the time the parcels arrive on day three, 1 out of every 4 gifts will be correct, and we select these by telling the recipient which deliveries to throw away." The researchers made sure to point out that these are just simulations, although successful ones are programmed in the known behaviors of entangled particles. So even though it effectively proved a way to change the results of an experiment in the past, 25% of the time at least, its ability to achieve a form of backward time travel still can't be compared to what we're used to seeing in movies and comic books. We are not proposing a time travel machine, but rather a deep dive into the fundamentals of quantum mechanics, said Arvidsson Shukur. These simulations do not allow you to go back and alter your past, but they do allow you to create a better tomorrow by fixing yesterday's problems today. The researcher also notes that the failure rate of their backward time travel system is somewhat reassuring, especially for physicists who depend on Einstein's theories of relativity and all of the science built upon those theories. That we need to use a filter to make our experiment work is actually pretty reassuring, he said. The world would be very strange if our time travel simulation worked every time. Relativity and all the theories that we are building our understanding of our universe on would be out of the window. To understand the experiment and its consequences, we would need to understand certain terms, such as quantum entanglement, CTCs, and wormholes. Quantum physics is the study of matter and energy at the atomic and subatomic levels, and it governs the behavior of particles so small that their actions defy the laws of classical physics. In this world of the very small, particles can exist in multiple states simultaneously, exhibit wave-particle duality, and become entangled with each other in ways that defy our everyday understanding of reality. Quantum entanglement, one of the most intriguing phenomena in quantum mechanics, describes the profound connection between two or more quantum particles. When entangled, these particles become inextricably linked, sharing the same properties even when separated by vast distances. Measuring the state of one entangled particle instantly reveals the state of the other, no matter how far apart they are. This instantaneous communication between entangled particles appears to transcend the limitations of space and time. This fascinating phenomenon in the quantum realm has been touted by scientists to have the potential to challenge our conventional understanding of time travel. While the concept of physically traversing through time remains a topic of debate and speculation, quantum entanglement offers a theoretical framework for manipulating information and influencing events in the past. This instantaneous communication, seemingly defying the limitations of the speed of light, has opened up new possibilities for exploring the nature of time. One approach involves utilizing entangled particles to send information back in time. Imagine sending an entangled particle into a hypothetical closed time-like curve, CTC, a theoretical path in space-time that allows a particle to return to its past. If the entangled particle inside the CTC could then interact with its counterpart in the present, it could theoretically transmit information backward in time, effectively altering the past. Another approach involves using quantum entanglement to manipulate the state of particles in the past. By exploiting the interconnectedness of entangled particles, it might be possible to retroactively modify the outcomes of past events. While these concepts remain theoretical and face significant challenges, the potential of quantum entanglement to influence the past cannot be ignored. It challenges our conventional understanding of causality and opens up new avenues for exploring the nature of time and reality. However, it is important to note that quantum entanglement does not allow for physical travel through time. The particles themselves would not physically move backward in time. Rather, information would be transmitted or the state of particles would be manipulated, potentially altering the past. The feasibility of these theoretical approaches remains an open question, and significant technological advancements would be required to harness the power of quantum entanglement for time travel. Nevertheless, the exploration of these possibilities continues to push the boundaries of our understanding of the universe and the fundamental laws of physics. Another thing to understand is the closed time-like curves, also known as CTCs. These are hypothetical paths within space-time that, if they existed, would allow an object or information to travel back in time to revisit its past. These curves represent a loop-like trajectory in space-time, theoretically permitting an entity to return to an event that it had previously experienced. Essentially, if one were to traverse a CTC, they could revisit an earlier point in their history. In the realm of general relativity and theoretical physics, CTCs are solutions to Einstein's field equations, allowing for certain geometries of space-time that seem to fold back on themselves, potentially creating this time-looping effect. However, renowned physicist Stephen Hawking has raised skepticism regarding the existence of CTCs. One of the significant constraints Hawking highlighted is the potential paradoxes that arise from their existence, such as the famous grandfather paradox. This paradox suggests that if one were to travel back in time and prevent their grandparents from meeting, it could create a contradiction, effectively negating the time traveler's existence. Hawking formulated the chronology protection conjecture in 1992, which posits that the laws of physics fundamentally prevent the formation of CTCs to protect the consistency of cause and effect, thereby avoiding paradoxes and maintaining a consistent flow of time. This conjecture is based on the idea that the laws of physics, as we understand them, forbid the existence of closed time-like curves. Hawking's skepticism about CTCs stems from the potential violations of causality and the challenges they pose to maintaining a coherent and consistent universe. He argued that closed time-like curves could disrupt the arrow of time and lead to inconsistencies in the cause and effect relationships that underlie our understanding of the universe. This skepticism reflects the inherent difficulties and paradoxes associated with the concept of time travel, especially when considering the consequences they might have on the fundamental laws of physics. Hawking's work has contributed significantly to the ongoing debate and exploration of the feasibility and consequences of time travel within the framework of established physics theories. Another concept that would help our understanding of the experiment is wormholes. Wormholes are hypothetical structures that connect two distant points in space-time, allowing for travel between different regions of the universe, or even between different times. They are like tunnels through space-time, similar to a shortcut through a mountain. The concept of wormholes was first introduced by physicist John Wheeler in 1955. He proposed that these tunnels could be created by rotating massive objects near the speed of light. The intense gravitational fields generated by these objects could warp space-time, creating a bridge between two points. Wormholes are described mathematically by Einstein's theory of general relativity. However, the existence of wormholes remains a matter of speculation, as they would require the presence of exotic matter with negative energy density, which has not yet been observed. According to general relativity, wormholes could exist in two forms, traversable and untraversable. Traversable wormholes would allow for travel through them, while untraversable wormholes would collapse before anything could pass through them. The existence of traversable wormholes would have profound implications for our understanding of the universe and the possibility of interstellar travel. They could provide a shortcut across vast distances, making it possible to travel to distant stars and galaxies. However, there are also potential hazards associated with wormholes. The intense gravitational fields around wormholes could rip apart objects that attempt to pass through them. Additionally, wormholes could be unstable and collapse at any time, trapping travelers inside. While the possibility of wormholes remains a topic of debate, they continue to fascinate scientists and capture the imagination of science fiction writers. The exploration of these hypothetical structures pushes the boundaries of our understanding of space-time and the universe. With the recent successful experiment and others around the world, there is hope that, while physically traveling back in time or into the future is still far-fetched, the science behind it can be worked out in our time. This means while you may not be able to go back in time to see certain events, your grandchildren or great-grandchildren can travel back in time to see what 2023 was like for you. Wouldn't that be so cool? Thanks for watching another episode of Voyager. While you're still here, make sure to click the video on your screen for more mind-blowing videos about space.